So hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today we're diving into how to manage deals inside of Pipedrive. Now if you haven't checked out our other video on Pipedrive overviewing how to manage deals, you can check that out in the link in the description. This video is sponsored by Pipedrive and a big thank you to their team for supporting Keep Productive. Now as you can see here, this is what it looks like inside of a deal inside of Pipedrive. And whilst we showed you a few experiences in the last one, we're going to build this from scratch just to demonstrate what you can do inside of a deal and what it means to manage a sales CRM and actually build a relationship with somebody. So as you can see here, this is the Bookshop deal that I started with John Appleseed, who's part of Bookshop Inc. Now, one of the first things you can do is actually build a bit more information on each person. And this actually helps a lot of the core experiences with activities, emails, invoices, and documents, and more. So in order to edit that field, you can go in and start interacting. For this example, you can see that, for example, you can label them as warm lead and even give them mobile phone numbers and email addresses. So here's something, I'm going to add in a number and press save all. So as you can see here, the participant can be added with more people. So in this case, you could actually add more people who are part of your sales process or more people that actually are involved in the deal that might become helpful later. Now, we said that John was part of the Bookshop Inc.'s organization. Well, you can go down here and actually add a bit more context. In this case, you can actually give the actual organization a name if a person isn't specifically useful. For example, if lots of people that change on a routine basis who aren't part of the deal might be involved in the process. You can also add an address as well, which is helpful for you and your team to be able to get direction information, especially when you're using the mobile versions and opening it up on the go. So as you can see here, this is really where all the magic happens, because this is where you can start building out information. And it's not only helpful for you, but it's also helpful for your team to be able to keep an idea of how the process is actually going. Now, one of the first things you can do is start taking notes. Now, notes can be really helpful, but they also can help add context for other people in the process. For example, if you work in a sales team, and you, for example, want to pass over to somebody else, then notes, activity logging, anything that you do is helpful for the other person to be able to get context and help the other person on the other end of the line know what's going on with the relationship between you and their company. So notes are helpful for that. I'll show you a little bit near the end how you can change person or, for example, ownership of a specific deal. So one thing that I really like inside of the notes, and something that I used quite regularly, is the image function. And this was particularly helpful, for example, if we had been to an event and I wanted to take a picture of a business card, well, you can link it in the image and save it inside of your notes. And you can use notes like any other sort of quick note taker with some of the bullet points and ordered list as well here. You can save it, and as you can imagine, it becomes part of the activity list. So as you can see here, I've actually been able to add a note, and as you can see, it comes sort of like a post-it note in the thread. Now, if you're collaborating with others inside of your team on a deal, you can actually add a comment and be able to interact with them here. Now, if you want to, you can cut through some of the noise and actually just go to straight to certain types of media as well. Now, logging activities is quite a helpful function, especially when you're trying to give a best picture for other people you're working with and for yourself of when the last interaction was. You can add anything from a meeting to a task all the way to a deadline and anything like emails as well. And you can actually link up emails too and actually start building a relationship and activity log of what actually happened. You can actually mark as done as well down here. Now you can see here that I have some logged activity down here, and I'm going to go into edit to show you what that looked like. So it says here on the 8th of January, I actually had a half an hour appointment with this person. And one of the functions that might be helpful, for example, for those folk who are doing more video-based stuff, is actually adding a video call. And you can integrate Zoom, Microsoft Teams, and Google Meet inside of this application, which is perfect for saving yourself time and inviting specific guests via email. So they'll be able to get all the information they need to know about the conversation. Now, as I said up here, I would show you how to transfer ownership. And it's really simple. You go over to transfer ownership and you choose what other team member you want to have associated with the deal. And it's very simple, and they'll be able to get it inside of their Pipedrive account. So for example, if the sale went a little bit sideways, or for example, it decided not to progress, you can actually convert it to a lead right here or export it in an XLS format. So one of the great things that you can do inside of your Pipedrive account is actually schedule activity. And for example, you can schedule a task or a call or even a deadline as well. And that's all really helpful for being able to keep track of what you need to do in the future of this process. Once you hit save, you can see planned activity here, and that will appear in your timeline. And you can actually mark it as done if you manage to get it done too. Over here, you can actually change the expected finish and closure date of the timeline. And once you do that, it naturally will update based on how the deal progress is being made. So that's a little bit more about how to manage a deal inside of Pipedrive. There are some really useful functions, especially the proposed times, which we'll cover in the next feature, about helping you pick the perfect time for a meeting with a client. So hopefully this was helpful. Please do let me know if you have any questions, and I'll talk to you all very soon. Cheerio.